All right, good Friday morning, everyone. It is time to talk about the markets with Jim Cramer on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. Jim, we had some weaker than expected job numbers, but what did you think?
Well, look, I don't want the Fed to have to tighten four times. Of course, the bank stocks sell off. They won six tightenings. By the way, I always like to credit. Carl mentioned Doug Kass. You should go read Doug Kass to get a little. Always have to keep the negatives in your face so you understand a negative thesis and what could go wrong with the yield curve, and that's very, very important. But I thought that in general, it was disappointing. And the disappointments in retail, and I know there were some people on Twitter really putting a hit on me this morning, saying, you know what, Jim, it's not just Amazon that's taking the jobs. Amazon is code for e-commerce. So lighten up.
Well, you know, we had declines in retail jobs in December, but Barclays upgrading Lowe's and Target.
I thought that the Lowe's upgrade was good and it's having an impact. Target, you're coming in on top of all this Amazon to buy Target, so I wasn't crazy about that. I did like Wayne Hood's piece, by the way, on why you should buy Macy's. That was very powerful. Transports, I love it when the market's led by Union Pacific and FedEx. Those are good signs. But against that, as I recognize that things have gotten a little euphoric, and you know, maybe we're due for a pullback. Remember, I did a piece the other day about the Commerce Department coming out on 232, which will then the bears will surface, take off their bull costumes and say, listen, I told you there's a trade war with China. Hey, there's been one forever. We've been losing. And I just think that, look, you want to keep in mind the negatives when you have the beginning of a very strong start. And that, a lot of that is because there's a lot of index money comes in the first couple of days. And that may be tapering. And also, I think to some degree, people were saying, I thought the economy was really, really strong and riding on the back of jobs numbers. And are we losing that prop? And that's the kind of chatter you're going to hear.
Well, it's interesting because this Barclays note said that 42 companies have made public statements about investing in employees based on tax reform.
Yeah, now 80 companies have offered bonuses. And I think that what you hear now is that there's going to be expansion and job and payment increases. But when you hear the quarters, you're also going to hear about the buybacks and the dividends. And that's going to be generally a rosy scenario.
All right. Meanwhile, Citi downgrading Roku. What did you think of this move?
You know, look, the key line is, first time people talked about it, is there's a March lockup expiration. And they did a sliver of the deal, and only a sliver of the company was sold when they came public. March expiration, when you get to February, that's going to put more pressure on the stock. Roku, Fitbit, okay? Roku, GoPro. These different device companies that excite you. Now, Roku did have a great quarter right out of the chute. But I just don't get too enthusiastic because if there's a lockup expiration, there'll be more supply. A lot of people are short Roku.
And the note also refers to competition, of course, Google.
Amazon, Google, they're all, you know, Apple. But that didn't, you know, that's what caused the short selling. So that's kind of old news. The new news is that people are going to be talking about this lockup expiration. And when you get that additional supply, it's going to hurt the stock.
All right, Jim, who do you have coming up on Med Money tonight?
Well, the stock that's the most down in the S&P is Constellation Brands, STC. I've got Rob Sands. I mean, I want to find out whether there really is revenue weakness or not because there's a $3 billion buyback. The company had some great gross margins, great earnings. So those who continue to sell it, it's in our bullpen for action alerts. I'm getting more intrigued, but I want to see what Rob has to say tonight.
I'm glad you mentioned Action Alerts because you're also hosting your monthly call next Wednesday.
Yes. And I've got some things, some predictions for the year, a bit of a look back, but also what we're talking about in the bullpen and what we bought, because I really want people to understand why we're buying.
Okay, and you and I are going to continue the conversation right now on actionalertsplus.com, so everyone should go join us there. Thank you, Jim.